Hello everybody. Today is the 26th of the May 2016, equal with the 6th of Khordad, 1395 in Persian calendar, which is the third month of the spring. And today is a little bit hot. I didn't want to pay attention to the poets and poems after finishing what I was speaking about the Sufi order, Safavids, that they could establish the Persian Empire, Persian Safavid Empire. But I had two questions from two students from different parts of Europe. They are working on Hafez, and they want to know how they could understand the meaning of the poems of Hafez. So today I try to speak about that and explain how it is possible to understand the meaning of the poems of Hafez as much as possible. Okay, before that, you know, we are speaking about Rumi, we spoke about Hafez, but we didn't pay attention enough to the Sa'di and also other people. I spoke about the other people, like Azizuddin and Asafi. I cited some texts from them, but nothing about Sa'di. Sa'di, I think it is not fair. So I am speaking about I start with the poem from Sa'di that I think is a beautiful poem and is a kind of advice, and I cite this advice to myself because I think it is very appropriate with my age and my situation and condition. Okay, I read it first in English, in Persian, then I translate it, then we go to the Hafez after that, okay? It is from Sa'di. هر دم از عمر می رود نفسی، چون نگه می کنم نمانده بسی. ای که 50 رفته در خوابی، مگر این 5 روزه دریابی. خجل آن کس که رفت و کار نساخت، کوس رحلت زدند و بار نساخت. خواب نوشین بامداد رحیل، باز دارد پیاده را ز سبیل. هر که آمد عمارتی نو ساخت، رفت و منزل به دیگری پرداخت. وان دیگر پخت همچنین هوسی. وین عمارت به سر نبرد کسی. وان دیگر پخت همچنان هوسی. وین عمارت به سر نبرد کسی. یار ناپایدار دوست مدار، دوستی را نشاید این قدار. نیک و بد چون همی بباید مرد، خنک آن کس که گوی نیکی برد. برگ عیشی به گور خویش فرست، کس نیارد ز پس تو پیش فرست. عمر برپست و آفتاب تموز، اندکی ماند و خواجه قره هنوز. ای تهی دست رفته در بازار، ترسمت پر نیاوری دستار.
Okay, I think it's not all of it is the abbreviation of the beginning of the Gulistan of Sa'di, which means the Rose Book of Sa'di. So I translate it. It says, the time is passing from my life, and when I watch it, when I see it, when I see that there is that nothing too much remained, means that I am getting old and it's a time to die and go. You are 50 right now, I think he's speaking with me, and you are asleep. You are 50 right now and you are still asleep. Maybe you could do something in the remaining days of your life, just 5 days. You know, he says just 5 days, means just a short time that remains. Embarrassing for somebody that's dying and didn't do anything. And they said, Kusa Rehlat, they said, okay, it's the time of go. I mean, caravan, they say, Kusa Rehlat, you know, they make a big noise with horn and ask anybody to be ready to go. And somebody who is not ready, I mean, the luggage is not on the back of the horse ready to move. And this person is embarrassing because he's not ready. He means that they ask you to die. You must be ready to die, but you are not ready yet. It is what he wants to say. Not ready, I mean, he means you didn't do something good, that you can do it, that you can die easily. And he says the sweet sleep of the morning, sweet sleep of the morning keeps some the traveler from going. He sleeps or she sleeps and he cannot continue his traveling. Everybody came, built a new building. Everybody who came to this world built a new building. Then he left or she left and gave the building to somebody else. Nothing remained for us. Nothing remained for us. One دیگر پخت همچنان هوس the other one is wishing about something new. One دیگر پخت wishing about something has new wishes, but this building doesn't remain for anybody. He means the world doesn't remain for anybody. Sorry, here is a little bit hot. I'm sweating. Okay. یار ناپایدار دوست مدار، دوستی را نشاید این قدار. He says don't take this word as your friend because it is not a loyal friend, and you shouldn't have friendship with the world because world is for nobody. Hafez says وین عجوز عروس هزار داماد است. He says this old woman, ajuz in Arabic means old woman. This old woman, which means the world, has seen thousands of grooms, and thousands means the world of too much. It doesn't mean 1,000, it means too much. Vin ajuz arus hazar damad ast. This world has seen many people like me and you, that we are coming and going, and still world is here as an old woman. Bin ajuz arus hazar damad ast, has seen 1,000 groom. نیک و بد چون همی بباید مرد، خنک آن کس که گوی نیکی برد. Good or bad, finally we should die. Good or bad, finally we should die. But it is good for somebody that did something good and going with the good things that he has done. He has a good name when he dies. برگ عیشی به گور خیش فرست، کس نیارد ز پس تو پیش فرست. Send something from this world to the other world for your comfort. If you do something good in the other world, you will be comfortable, and after that nobody could help you, just you can help yourself. I'm assuming it myself. I mean, it's the advice of the Sadi to me. Umr, it is so beautiful, this one. Umr برف است و آفتاب تموز، اندکی ماند و خواجه قره هنوز، or خواجه قره هنوز، or خواجه قره هنوز. I think we can pronounce in three ways. Umr برف است. The life is like a snow, snow. Umr برف است و آفتاب تموز. Life is like a snow in front of the sun of the June. Sun of the June, especially in the eastern countries, sun of June is very hot and could melt the snow so easily. So our life is like a snow in front of the sun of the June, passing so fast and no way. اندکی مانده، just a little remained. خواجه قره هنوز. خواجه means great man. خواجه قره هنوز. خواجه is still proud of himself. He is thinking I have a lot of money and you know just, yeah. خواجه قره هنوز or it could be خواجه still proud or خواجه deceived by the world. He is still thinking to make new palaces and make more money and something like that. Or it could have this meaning, I don't know if it's correct or not. خواجه قره هنوز. قره means beginning of the month, you know, in lunar system, beginning of month start with the new moon. قره is the beginning of the moon, so it may have this meaning also, that life is past and he's still he has the wishes of the beginning of the life. You know, he has stupid wishes. You know what I'm saying? He's thinking about more money. You know, all of us, we need money, especially me. But what I want to say, that it is not the only thing that we can do. Of course, what Sadi wants to say, ای توهی دست رفته در بازار، ترسمت پر نیاوری دستار. He says, You have gone with empty hand. Tohidas means empty hand, and it means poor. You have gone to the market, to the Walmart, or I don't know, Hochfilet or whatever. You have gone there with empty hand. You don't have any money. You have gone to the market. How? Tarzamat poor neyo. I fear that you come back with the empty basket because you don't have money. They don't sell anything to you, and it is what I mean. Sadi means you don't do anything. I don't do anything good. Then there is no result. When you don't do anything good, then there is no result. Just let me explain in English. Most of the time, we go as an example, we go to ourselves. But in Persian language, usually we say you. But I don't mean you. I mean everybody. So it's a difference. Okay, it was from Saadi, and I think it's a very beautiful part and beautiful advice from Saadi. Okay, sometimes, no, most of the time, when I make a video, I watch it again to see which kind of mistake I made, usually about the English language. Okay, I said rise for the past tense of the rose, rise for the past tense of rise, which was mistake, it is rose. And I said many times historian facts, I meant historical facts. Yes, it is, I don't know. I said Soviet Revolution, Bolshevik Revolution, it was 1979. No, it is 1917. Yeah, 1917, October 1917. 1979 is the revolution in Iran. And I said several times poems and poets, I made a mistake in using them. And several times I said they made a building. I think I should say built a building, not made a building. And I said about Ghazan. Ghazan means poet. And a friend asked me, what do you mean Ghazan? Because we had a Mongol king in Iran. His name was Ghazan Khan. You know, the Mongols, when there was a newborn baby, when they wanted to name him or her, they were going outside. And the first thing they could see, they put the name of it on the child. And for Ghazan Khan, I think they went out and they see a pot, P-O-T, pot, something we cook inside, and they put the name Ghazan Khan. And I'm not joking them, just is the name. And it is their tradition, no humiliation. I didn't want to do that, just say Ghazan Khan. I remember the story. And also we have Kopak Khan. Kopak in Turkish means dog. They have seen dog first and they say Kopak Khan. Of course, he was not a king, just I have heard this name or read in a book. And I said, okay, what do you do with the books? When I was speaking about the Persianization, yes, they burned books many times in Iran. They burned many books. I don't want to say the story right now, but again, they couldn't do that. I mean, yes, we lost a lot, a very, very big heritage. And we don't have access to these books anymore. But again, they couldn't ruin Iran. I mean, they ruined Iran. They couldn't ruin the culture of Iran. And still it's going on. And about, I said, you should have tolerance and endurance, both of them. About the, I don't know where I said that, but I remember that I said about tolerance. I mean, endurance in front of the hunger, thirst, and difficult life. Something else that I want to say, you know, that Persian alphabet is Arabic alphabet. I said the Muslims changed our alphabet, but they couldn't change our language. And we have 8 letters in our alphabet. And also, I remember that I said Arabs, they don't have 4 alphabets. No, I meant they don't have 4 letters. G, Ch, P, J. And we have 8 letters in our alphabet that they are extra. We don't need them. And it makes a lot of difficult for us. I mean, it doesn't matter how educated you are. It doesn't matter how sophisticated you are. It doesn't matter how learned person you are. You may make these mistakes. And sometimes it's embarrassing in front of me. For example, for me, I don't know if I make this mistake, you know, if my students see that and they say, okay, he doesn't know how to read and write, and it's a big problem, you know, it's a big problem. And also we have problem about the about typing on computer, it goes to, because Arabic from the right to left, Latin from left to right, too much problem. It is a big, big problem when we are typing or something. And but again, we can tolerate that. But what about the eight letters that we have extra and we don't need that? For example, we have three S, and just I should know how to use it. I mean, there is no instruction for that. Just as I must guess when I use this S, when I use the other S, and when I use the other S. And also we have a Z, you know, eight extra letters that different words, they, we use these different letters, and there is no instruction for them. Just we need to know ourselves. And even we don't pronounce them. They are Arabic and we don't have their pronunciation in Persian. So they are extra. And they make a big problem. Before, I don't know, 3-4 years ago, I wrote a short letter and asked to omit these letters. Then many people, they have done that. I'm not the only person that I have done that. But I see again, it makes problem because I don't know, the it is not beautiful. And also we have still the problem of right to left and left to right. And finally, I have reached to this conclusion that we must use Roman letters. There is no option. There is no option because, you know, the new generation that don't have time, you know, just like us when we were in elementary school, just books of Hafez and Sa'di and Rumi and other things, you know, just classics, read them and learn them and love them. You know, these days with internet and chatting and I don't know, boyfriend, girlfriend, they don't have time for these things. So we must do something about that. But I see many people make these mistakes, and then everybody says you are illiterate, and also too much problem in writing and reading because we don't use, and also we don't use vowels. We have vowels, but we don't use vowels. So I must guess what is the true pronunciation of that. And many times we can understand what is the true, I mean the proper or the good pronunciation, but sometimes we make mistakes because there are words that never we hear, just we have seen in a book and we have seen it just two times, I don't know, in all of our life. Then we make a mistake. We and it's difficult. We must, according to me, we should change our alphabet. There is no other option. I know that our alphabet is very beautiful. It's very beautiful. I mean, calligraphy is so beautiful and we like it, but there is no option. There is no option. If we want to go forward, there is no option. It was what I wanted to say about the Persian alphabet. And I said that because I see the many foreign students that they want to learn Persian, they have this problem. And because of that, I spoke about that, and I think we need to do that as soon as possible. Okay, we go to the Hafiz. How we could understand what is the true meaning of the poem of Hafiz? It is about his lover as a girlfriend or wife or whatever, or lover as God. How we could understand that? I say it is difficult. You know why it is difficult? Because I said that in mysticism, Persian mysticism, they said God is our lover. I said, why they do that? Because it was time of hate. Everybody says, I am anger of the God. You know, the Mongols, when they attacked, I think in one of the cities, Neshabur, I think, I'm not sure. Somebody asked, what is happening? He says, it's the wind of the anger of God that is blowing. They were saying these Mongols, just the anger of God, angry God. And also Tamerlane, there is a book. It is not his book, but something. They say it is his book, but no, not, it is not his book. Tazuki Temuri, he says, I am the sword of anger of God. I am killing you because God is angry with you. You know, the time was the time of hate, time of killing, and also, I mean, this time is not so peaceful. Just we say that time was bad, and people like Rumi and Hafiz and other people, they said no, God is not bad. God is love, and God is my lover, and I love God, and God loves me. You see, Rumi doesn't speak about the hell. Hafiz doesn't speak about the hell. At least I don't remember. These people, they don't speak about the hell. All of the time they speak about my lover, which is God, and they are speaking about affection and something. Forget the hell. Just paradise and God. You know what I'm saying? So they are speaking of God as their lover. So it makes it difficult to understand what do they mean exactly here. In Rumi, we don't have too much problem about that because he's more clear. But about Hafiz, we don't know. He's speaking about the God or his lover. And sometimes it's difficult. But altogether, you know, first you should know Persian very well. I mean, Hafiz knows the exact meaning of the words. He knows exactly. You know, sometimes we are careless. We use, I don't know, different evening for night, night for evening, afternoon for evening. But Hafiz, no. Hafiz is very careful. And he is a master of language and words. He knows exactly what do they mean. So we must be careful. For example, if he says sahar, what does it mean, sahar? If he says soap, what does it mean, soap? We couldn't confuse the meaning of the word. Etymology is very important if we want to understand the meaning of the poems of the Hafiz. Okay, the poem that I read last time, and also I put a video that with the translation from Shajarian, and one of these students asked me how we could understand that this poem is not about the God. So I read it again, and I have read it before, cited before. صبح است ساقیا قدحی پر شراب کن دور فلک درنگ ندارد شتاب کن زان پیشتر که عالم فانی شود خراب ما را ز جام باده گلگون خراب کن خورشید می ز مشرق ساغر طلوع کرد گر برگ عیش می طلبی ترک خواب کن. Beautiful. روزی که چرخ از گل ما گوزه ها کند زنهار کاسه ما پرشراب کن ما مرد زهد تو و طامات نیستیم با ما به جام باده صافی خطاب کن کار ثواب باده پرستی حافظا برخیز و عزم جزم به کار ثواب کن. خب you see here, I mean I have translated before, you can see that, and also you can see this on the YouTube from the Shajarian that I put with the translation. Sophas, this is morning, and the wine boy make a cup full of wine. It is soap, it is not sahar. Sahar, you know, sahar is the time that they say in the Islamic and the Arif mysticism, they say sahar, I mean before sunrise, which is dark, still dark. It's a time, if you pray to God may accept your wishes. It's a time for praying, you know, it's a sahar. But soap is soap, 7 o'clock is soap, 8 o'clock is soap, it's not the time of praying. You can pray, but according to them, it is very rare that God accepts what you say. But sahar is different. Sahar is dark, maybe 4 o'clock, 4:30, something like that. It is sahar. It's the time of praying to the God. They say the doors of the heaven is open, and God is listening to you, and may grant your wish, right? So, here, صبح است. So he's speaking, you know, it is morning, I need a cup of wine. Wine boy, it is what he says. And when I read all of these books, I don't see anything that it doesn't give me any clue that he's speaking about the God. About the God, دور فلک درنگ ندارد شتاب کن. The time doesn't stop so hurry to the wine boy. زان پیشتر که عالم فانی شود خراب ما را ز جام باده گلگون خراب. Because before this word ruins, before this word ruins, make me ruin, make me drunk. In fact, from the wine. I'm not translating word by word because I have done it before. خورشید می ز مشرق ساغر طلوع کرد. گر برگ عیش می طلبی ترک خواب کن. The sun of the wine rose from the east of the cup. There is nothing about God. I don't see anything about the God. So some people I have seen there on the YouTube and other places, they are master, they are saying it is about God. It is their idea, but I don't believe that. I don't believe that. I think I don't see anything about the God here. It is about mine. گر برگ عیش میطلبی ترک خواب کن. If you want to have fun, okay, wake up. Don't sleep. روزی که چرخ از گل ما کوزه ها کند، زنهار کاسه سر ما پرشنا کن. The time that they want to make a clay from our soil, when I die, from my soul, okay, the make my skull full of wine. There is nothing about God according to me. ما مرد زهد و تامات نیستیم. با ما به جام باده صافی خطاب کن. I am not a pious man. حافظ says, I am not a pious man. Speak with me about wine. Okay. کار ثواب باده پرستی حافظا. The good thing is to worship the wine. The good thing is the worship of wine. Hafiz, get up, stand up and go for the good thing is go drink wine. So it is, I don't see anything about the God. And also it is soap, it is not sahar. Soap is 7-8 o'clock, it is not sahar. We go to, I show the other cases how he speaks. Even he may speak about the sahar, but again it doesn't mean that he's speaking about the God. Hafiz has many things. We shouldn't speak all of the time when he speaks about the things, no, that he's speaking about the God. No, it is not like that. You know, I think that, you know, one of the problems that we have, you know, that, you know, this Hafiz all of the time is speaking about the wine, about the lover, about, I don't know, these kind of things. Okay, and he was living in an Islamic country, Islamic society, and people loved his poems. So what to do? He's speaking about bad things, which is forbidden, which is haram in Islam. Then people, they try to say, you know, he means from wine God, he means from lover God. You know, they try to justify what he says. Sometimes it is true, but many times it's not true. And he's speaking about this word with lover as girlfriend, wife, or whatever. But people try to justify, to say, no, he doesn't mean something, he doesn't mean wine, he means the wine of God, you know, something like that. And the Orientalists, after that, they say, they ask our idea. For example, as a historian, they ask my idea, what does it mean? And I said, you know, no, he doesn't mean wine, he means the wine of God. Then these Orientalists, that they were coming from other countries, they say, you know, it is their language, they know better. So they copied us. And they said what we said, they repeated what we said, right? But it's not right. We should change that. We should change that, and we say no. Many times he's speaking about the love of this world, not love of the God. And I could claim that. I know my language very well, and I have been with Hafiz for 50 years, all of my life. I could claim that I could understand what he says. I don't see these signs. I don't see these signs in all of the poems of the Hafiz. Most of them are about, some of them are about the God, but many of them are not about the God or these things. Okay, then I go to the other poem. سحرم دولت بیدار به بالین آمد، گفت برخیز که آن خسرو شیرین آمد. قدحی درکش و سرخوش به تماشا به خرام، تا ببینی که نگارت به چه آیین آمد. Here again سحر I said it is before the sunrise. Okay. I woke up, something or somebody woke me up and said, wake up to see that this sweet Khosrow, I don't know, Khosrow could be king, that sweet king came. We may think that he's speaking about the God, but here is a story, he's speaking about Shah Shuja that came to the Shiraz and conquered or captured Shiraz. It is pure story. It is not anything with the God. And we read all of the poem until the end. We don't see anything about the God. I cannot read all of them because then video becomes too long. But it is, he speaks about Sahar, but Sahar is not about the God or something. It's a history. He's speaking about the history. Yeah. And we go to the other one. This one could speak about the God. This one that I'm reading could speak, because there are many signs. There is nothing about this world. You could see that everything is about God.
ما درس سحر در ره میخانه نهادیم، محصول دعا در ره جانانه نهادیم. در خرمن صد زاهد عاقل زند آتش، این داغ که ما بر دل دیوانه نهادیم. سلطان ازل گنج غم عشق به ما داد، تا روی در این منزل ویرانه نهادیم. در دل ندهم ره، در دل ندهم ره پس از این مهر، در دل ندهم ره پس از این مهر بتان را. مهر لب تو، مهر لب او بر در این خانه نهادیم. در خرقه از این بیش منافق نتوان بود، بنیاد از این شیوه رندانه نهادیم. سو بیوتیفول. چون می رود این کشتی سرگشته که آخر، جان در سر آن گوهر یک دانه نهادیم. المنت لله که چما بی دل و دین بود، آن را که لقب عاقل و فرزانه نهادیم. قانع به خیالی ز تو بودیم، چو حافظ یارب چه گدا همت و بیگانه نهادیم. اوکی، هیر ما درس سحر در ره میخانه نهادیم. He says what we learned in the سحر before the dawn, D-A-W-N, dawn, huh? He says what we learned in the dawn, in the سحر before sunrise, we put everything in the road of the bar, wine house. He says I put all of them, means I wasted all of them in the road of the wine house. And I put the product of the praying, I put the product of the paying in the road of my lover. Lover here is God. Okay? Sultan Azal means the king of eternity, the king of the beginning. It's God. You know, you see the signs of the God here. Sultan Azal, Genjiqam Esh Bemadat. He's the king of the beginning, eternity, gave the treasure of sadness to me, to us. Again, he speaks about the God. He's speaking the creation day. He gave us at the same time. آسمان بار امانت نتوانست کشید. The other poem. آسمان بار امانت نتوانست کشید. قرعه کار به نام من دیوانه زدن. Because there is a story, religious story, I think in Quran. He says when God wanted to create a human being, he offered the deposit of being human being to the mountain, to the sky, to different things. They said no, we cannot, it is too much. Asaman sky, Asaman is Asaman bar amanat natavanest kashid. The sky said no, I cannot accept this deposit. It is is translation. Asaman bar amanat natavanest kashid. Sky didn't accept the deposit of being human being. قرعه کار به نام من دیوانه زدن. And the lottery came to the name of me as a crazy person. Hafiz says قرعه کار به نام من دیوانه زدن. He says, so he just speak about the day of creation, the day that God created human being. He speaks about that day, that in that day God gave me the treasure of sadness of love. God gave to me. So it is my destiny from the beginning. It is what Hafiz says. Ta rooj dar in manzil virane nahadam. In the time that I came to this ruined manzil, this ruined home. Manzil, let me say, what does it manzil? Manzil, you know, in Arabic said you have a stem of verb or word, which is tree, like fa'il, maf'ul. Different, you know, it goes to the different structures and different meaning. Manzil, you know, when caravan goes from here, for example, to the Canada, there are different motel, you can say motel, but yeah, like motel, like that. The travelers stay there and at night, and they are feeding their horses, their camels, their mules, their donkeys, and they sleep themselves. It is manzil, the place that they could stay, but it's not a permanent place. It is a temporary place. They cannot stay there forever. Though right now in Iran they say, come to my manzil, but they don't know. No, again, there is temporary. But people, they mean somewhere, their home. It's which has a permanent meaning. But manzil is not permanent, it's temporary. Hafiz says, ta rooj dar in manzil virane nahadam. He says, to this home which is temporary. Manzil means temporary home, like motel, like hotel, something like that. It doesn't,
never they speak about the place that they could stay forever. Nobody could think like that. Even but they emphasize on it. This is temporary place, manzil, something that we are as a traveler we are going and we stay here, and from there we go to the other world. So he says they have the king of the king, which means God here, has given the sadness of love to me at the creation day. From the time that I am in this temporary world. So everything is about God. We could see that. It is something up, higher. I am not saying that love of this world is low, just I am saying he's speaking spiritual, right? So we could see that. It is clear here. Okay, it is okay, Al-Minnatu Lillah. I didn't want to translate, but it's beautiful. Al-Minnatu Lillah ki chuma bidelodin bud ra ke laqab aqal farzan nahadim. Thanks God, the person that we were calling him, that he's a wise man, and he's a good man. He was he was infidel like me, and he shamed. Hafiz. Okay, we go to the other things. Hafiz is so funny, you know. Yeah. دوش وقت آدر پوئم. دوش وقت سحر از قصه نجاتم دادند، من در آن ظلمت شب آب حیاتم دادند، بی خود از شعشعه پرتو ذاتم کردند، باده از جام تجلا صفاتم دادند. چه مبارک سحری بود، چه فرخنده شبی. سحر، you see سحر، dawn, dawn. چه مبارک سحر. When you have سحر as a keyword in a poem, you must be suspicious that he is speaking about God and praying in the سحر. When you see Sahar, you should be suspicious. Your brain start to think, to scan. Maybe he's speaking about God here. Sahar is one of these words. چه مبارک, one of these words. چه مبارک سحری بود. چه فرخنده شبی. آن شب قدر که این تازه براتم دادند. بعد از این روی منو آینه وصف جمال که در آنجا خبر از جلوه ذاتم دادند. من اگر کام روا گشتم و خوشدل چه عجب. مستحق بودم و اینها به زکاتم دادند. هاتف آن روز به من مژده این دولت داد که بدان جور و جفا صبر و نباتم دادند. این همه شهد و شکر که از سخنم میریزد اجر صبری است که از آن شاخ و نباتم دادند. همت حافظ و انفاس سحرخیزان بود. Again you have سحر here. که زبند غم ایام نجاتم دادند. Again here we have سحر. Dush, last night, during the Sahar, in the dawn, they saved me from the sadness. And in the middle of darkness, they give me the water of life. Water of life, you know, water of life, they were believing that there is a water of life somewhere in darkness. Maybe in Norway or Sweden or some part of Canada. I don't know where it was. This is, of course, it's mythology. And if you go there and find this water and drink this water, then you live forever. And there is a story about Alexander the Macedonian and one of the prophets, Khizr, and they went there and they found the water, something like that. There is a story about that, but there is no time for that right now. I may say the story later. He says in the middle of that darkness, I mean night, Sahar, before, they gave me the water of life. بی خود از شعشعه پرتو ذاتم کردند، باده از جام تجلا. You know he's speaking about his spiritual mood and the good thing that he had last night. چه مبارک سحری بود، چه فرخون. It was a wonderful and it was a wonderful, I don't know مبارک. It was a wonderful night and it was a very nice night. آن شب قدر که این تازه براتم دادن. شب قدر، لیلت القدر in Arabic. قدر is a night in Islamic tradition, that there are three nights, I think 21st, 23rd and 27th of Ramadan. There are three nights. They say if you pray until the God may grant your wishes. Okay, Laylatul Qadr. Ma adraka ma Laylatul Qadr is in Quran. How do you don't know the value of the night of Qadr. Ma adraka ma Laylatul Qadr. القدر و ما ادراک ما لیلت القدر. لیلت القدر خیر من الف شهر. It is in Quran. It's the Arabic verses in Quran. و ما ادراک ما لیلت القدر. لیلت القدر خیر من الف شهر. You don't know how valuable is the translation what I'm saying. You don't know how valuable is the night of Qadr. Night of Qadr is better than 1,000 months. It means if you pray in that night is better than you pray in 1,000 months. It is in Quran. So it is a valuable night for the Muslims to pray and ask from the God what they want. It says in that night they give me good thing, good news. And I don't translate all of it. Himmat Hafiz is the last verse. همت حافظ انفاس سرخیزان بود که زبند غم ایام نجاتم دادن. همت حافظ is my hard working of the Hafiz and praying of the people that they wake up in dawn, in sahar, D-A-W-N, and they pray because of the praying of these people, they saved me from the sadness of the days. So here you see again It is mystic, right? It is about Irfan. He's speaking about the God and about the Sahar praying and they saved him. They there was a good news from the God and he's not sad anymore. We can say this one. It is not something about his lover or this world. And the other one, which is last one. مزرع سبز فلک دیدم و داس مه نو. یادم از کشته خیش آمد و هنگام درو. گفتم ای بخت بخفتیدی و خورشید دمید. گفت با این همه سابق نومید مشو. گر روی پاک و مجرد چو مسیحا به فلک، از چراغ تو به خورشید رسد صد پرتو. تکه بر اختر شب دوز مکن کین عیار، تاج کابوس ببرد و کمر کیخسرو. گوشوار زر و لال ارچه کران دارد گوش، دور خوبی گذران است نصیحت بشنو. چشم بد دور ز خال تو که در عصر حس بدقی راند که برد از مه خورشید گرو. آسمان گو مفروشین عظمت کن در اش خرمن مه به جوی خوشه پروین به دو جو. آتش زهد و ریا خرمن دین خواهد بسوخت. حافظ این خرقه پشمینه بیانداز برو. This is a translation. I saw the green form of the world and the cycle. S-I-C-K-L-E. Cycle of the new moon. He resembles the new moon as a cycle that wants to harvest the green farm of the world. And I remember from what I have done, what I have cultivated, and the time now is the time of cycling. What I have done in my life is the time of production. What I have done, and I remembered what I have done. I remembered I was thinking what I have done in my life, and now is the time of product. I want to see what is the product of my life. گفتم ای بخت بخفتیدی و خورشید دمید. I said my luck, you stepped and sun rose. So you see here he is speaking that about the sunrise, before the sunrise. He says I stepped, I didn't pray, and now sun is up and God doesn't accept. گفتم ای بخت بخفتیدی و خورشید دمید. I said my luck, you slept, means I stepped. And the sun rose. گفت با این همه از سابقه نومید مشو. Said yes, but again don't be disappointed from the grace of God. Don't be disappointed. Maybe helps. گر روی پاک و مجرد چون مسیحا به فلک، از چراغ تو به خورشید رسد صد پرتو. This one is beautiful. گر روی پاک و مجرد چون مسیحا به فلک، از چراغ تو به خورشید رسد صد پرتو. If you go pure, مجرد means single, because Jesus was single, right?
Masiha means sing Jesus. Okay, he's speaking about Jesus. Jesus, the prophet of Christian. Geravi paak mujarrad. If you go like Jesus, pure means nothing wrong. And single mujarrad here means single, but the better meaning is here that he doesn't have any attachment to this word mujarrad. Jesus didn't have any attachment to this word. Mujarrad means single, but here I think it means somebody that didn't have any attachment of this to this world. He didn't want anything from this world. You know, no wife, no child, nothing. No pleasure from this world. Garavi Pauk Mujarrad. Yeah, there is a story, you know, Jesus, when, you know, they say skies is seven floors, okay? Seven stories, seven floor, and Jesus went, he reached to the fourth floor. They say stop. He said, no, I want to go upper. I don't remember exactly what was the story. Then they said, you have a needle. Because of this needle from the other world, you cannot go upper. And I don't know, he threw away the needle. I don't remember. But there is a story that Jesus went to the skies. In the mysticism, Persian mysticism, there is a story. But here it says, Garabi Pak Mujarrad Cho Masiha Be Falak. If you go like Jesus, pure and not attached to this world, if you go to the skies, as Chiraq to be Khurshid Rasad Sad Parto, from your bulb, B-U-L-B, from your bulb, many lights to the sun. You know what that means? It means you become so, you have a lot of light. You become so shiny. You are shining in the way that you give light to the sun, not sun to you. You know what I'm saying? Because you are not attached to this world. You are free from this world. You don't want anything from this world. And you are pure and innocent, like Jesus. It's beautiful. Garavi paak mujarrad cho masiha be falak. از چراغ تو به خورشید رسد صد پرتو. تکیه بر اختر شب دوز مکن، کین عیار تاج کاووس ببرد و کمر کیخسرو. Again, I'm not going to translate all of it, but here it says don't depend, don't trust to the world, this world, because this عیار means thief. Very smart thief, something like that. Translation is not simple, that he took the throne of the Kheykhosrow, one of the Persian kings, and the Kavus and the belt of Kheykhosrow. Means all of them gone in front of the world. Don't trust to the world. آسمان گو مفروش این عظمت کندر اش، آسمان گو مفروش این عظمت کندر اش، خرمن مه به جوی، خوشه پروین به دو جو. Say to a sky, don't say I am so big, I am so great. Say to the sky that don't say that I am great, which is in the which in the road of love, or which in love, the skies, I sell it to one body. This sky, I don't know the name of this star in the English, I don't know. Mah is moon. He says I sell the moon to one body, and Khushay Parvin, I don't know what is the name of Parvin in the English, to two bodies. Means they are worthless to me in the road of love. So this one, you could see, is a mystical poem. I know it is a little bit difficult. It's a little bit difficult, but if you have any problem, please send the poem to me, then I try to help you. Okay, have a good day.